Hello, my name's Dwayne and I'm the course leader at Huddersfield New College for Computing and IT. This morning what we're going to do is we're going to have a look at a basic programming setup for Pascal, which is a procedural programming language, and it's going to give you the basics, the basic introduction into programming, which is an absolute fundamental of the computing course. So we're going to work with a basic programming language called Pascal. We're going to use an IDE which is called Lazarus, and this is a free application that you can download from home if you wanted to have a go at this yourself. I'll put information in the description. In this programming language of Pascal, we're going to generate a small application that takes two numbers and adds them together and then outputs them to the screen. Now, this is a console application, so it's not going to be visual. It's all going to be very basic text on a screen that asks for commands and then outputs a simple result. So in this very simple program, we've got this very basic construct here. So we've got the program, a temporary program name, and an endpoint to which the program ends. In between there, we need to have a couple of system setups. So we're first of all telling the system that it needs to use system utilities so that it makes the program run correctly. And without that, we'll get lots of errors. It's really important that indentation is done to make your program nice and neat. And if you get errors, it's much easier to find those errors. The next part, I'm going to create something called a variable. So a variable is something that is dynamic in nature, and we can set the contents of that variable at any point during the program. So whilst the program is running, I can change that variable to whatever contents I want. So I'm going to create three variables. We're going to have num1, we're going to have num2, and we're going to have result. And we're going to define those as an integer. So an integer is a whole number, so 1, 3, 10, 100, things like that. Now that I've declared those variables, I'm going to start the basics of the program. So I'm going to put in the word begin. Notice that when begin is typed, it picks up the end. So this is the area in which I'm going to create my program. All the code needs to be between these two areas. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write out to the screen, I'm going to ask the user of the program to enter some information. And I do that by creating or typing write line, write ln. Then in parentheses and a semicolon at the end, I'm going to put in some contents. And those contents, or rather the content of this output, depending on that content, needs to be presented in a different way. The first way, if I'm presenting a question or a string of characters going to the screen, I need to put them into single quotes. And this treats it as a string. So, for example, please enter your first number. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to put something called a read line. So a read line stops the program or pauses the program and looks for some kind of entry into the system. Now, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do read line with a semicolon at the end. And that's going to stop my program from closing. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to test to make sure that the program works correctly. I'm going to finish my mistakes. So as we can see, as the program has run, please enter your first number. It's run that command there. So far, the program works. I'm going to add another read line. This read line is going to read the contents of the user's input. And I'm going to store that in my variable num1. Oops. So in this instance, I'm not going to put the num1 in single quotes. I'm just going to type num1. And that's going to tell the system that what I'm typing there, what I'm using, is one of my variables. So it doesn't confuse it as a string. It knows it's a variable to store the data that is being read from the user. I'm then going to copy and paste this and reuse this code. And I'm just going to make a couple of changes. Please enter your second number, and I'm going to change that variable to num2. So when we run this program in a second, it's going to take a number from the first input. It's going to store it in the variable num1. It's then going to move on. It's going to write out the second question or statement to read a new number. And that'd be stored in num2. So let's have a test. So please enter first number, let's enter 2. Please enter second number, 1 to 3. Now this time when I hit enter, the program is going to close. So I've not done anything with that data. So we need to rectify that. So what we need to do is we need to take our final variable, which we've not yet used, which is this result. If I type out result, then need to do a colon and an equals. So this is going to allow us to store some data within a variable during the runtime. So this is not whilst the variables are being taken from a user input, but rather contents that we are using dynamically in the background of the running of the program. And very simply, all I'm going to do is just say num1 plus num2. So it should take our variables, add them together, and store them in the result. Now, if I run this, nothing's still going to happen visually. It's not going to give me any output. So I need to tell the system to tell me the answer. So forgetting those single quote marks, I'm working with a string. So your total is, I'm going to put a comma here, and I'm going to put a space after the word is, and you'll see why in a second. And I'm going to type out the name of the variable I want to print to the screen. So what's going to happen on this line is it's going to take the word your total is with a space at the end of it. It's going to write it to the screen. And then finally, it's going to give me the contents of the variable result of which we did the calculation on the previous line. So if we test that, please enter your first number. We'll go with 2 again. Second number, we'll go with 3. Your total is 5. If I don't put that space in here, then I would get your total is 5 without a space. So it's really important to keep clean code and understand how variables are added to strings of text. So there we go. That is our very basic calculator. Now that we've completed this very basic program in Pascal, hopefully you'll have a better understanding of how this procedural programming language works. Please do have a go at this language. Use the resources that are in the description to help you better and further develop your skills in programming. I'll also drop in a few more links of the different languages that we do at Huddersfield New College. Programming can be really fun if you really try, put your hard effort in there so that you further develop that understanding and build on those logic skills. Thank you for watching, and we hope to see you soon at Huddersfield New College in the Computing and IT Department.